Hi and welcome to Ultrasign and Andreas.
Yeah, I'm gonna play something very strange, but it's beautiful in its strange way, and it's a tribute to the people of Poland and Ukraine, and also to Martin Gore from Depeche Mode for writing such a beautiful song. And this is a Polish folk quartet singing basically Polish folk music, but they also cover famous songs. Okay. And this is their version of Enjoy the Silence.
Okay. Sounds fantastic. But okay, let's check it out.
Thank you.
Wow, I
Yeah.
need to know more about this group.
Yeah, it's weird, but it's also great, I think. It's like it's unreal somehow. I don't know. It shouldn't actually be something I like, but I love it.
Yeah, in the, it could feel like a mishmash from the beginning, you know, with that song and this traditional music, but I think it fit perfect, and I really okay. I can't too much about traditional Polish songs, but it feels like it, you know, when. And I have a thought about this kind of singing is kind of traditional, you know, high tones
Yeah.
so it feels. Well, I like it. It's hard to describe. it's almost like I need to Google a bit about it because I really want to know more.
Yeah, but it's something about this that feels so naive and genuine somehow that it is what it is and they sound like they sound, and it's like it's cute somehow.
Yeah, it is, and the video help you to feel that, you know, with this, you're standing and dancing a little bit like.
Yeah, nothing happens. It's just this weird contrast between their color and the background that is almost like that's green screen or something, because it's not the same color scheme and light. But I don't know, it just feels a bit unreal, but I just like it very much.
I follow a few different music essay channels, I guess you can call them, on YouTube, and this type of folk music, I think in that case it was a Bulgarian folk music group, as an example, but the way they are singing is very similar to this, and I really can't remember half of all the really different things they do when comparing to folk music from other countries. But the thing with East Slavic folk singing in particular, it has a really specific and special, can you call it timbre? Like a special tone. It's really hard to nail these type of harmonics that they do, and some of that went really through in this song. That what they are doing are really difficult to pull off, because to be able to get that type of tone that they get is far from something that any type of singer can perform, really. So I don't really have the words for it right now, but I am really impressed by this, and I'm really impressed that humans are able to sing this way, because it's really otherworldly in a way.
Very good description. Now I know why I recognize the name. They have been in Eurovision,
Oh, okay.
2019. So, yeah, the name felt us. Yeah. However, a great track and a great version of this song. This song is, you know, is. It's bigger than the band that did it, and it's like, you know, it's one of them, the song that everyone knows, I think, and to do that cow in that way, this way. I think it's fit together. You know, it's good.
Yeah, it just shows the song. I mean, it shows how good a song it is, because it's actually destroyed the way. I mean, it's played everywhere all the time.
Yeah.
Forever, you know. But like this, it's more like a hymn. It's just nice, simple, beautiful song.
Do you know if they use traditional instrument or?
It didn't sound like it.
Some parts. I don't know what you call the munjiga.
Maybe.
But it would be interesting to know.
It's called the juice harp.
The juice harp. Okay, I think I like munjiga better. but okay. Yeah, great track. I enjoy the sound, if I can say it like that.
Yeah,
you can.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
Bye.